Just wanted to give you guys my full in-depth review of the second generation of the XPS 13. This one has the 6th gen Skylake Intel processor in it. The model that I have here is the one with the i7, 8 gigs of RAM and 256 gig drive. They do come in a couple of different flavors, the i3, the i5, and the i7. You get about a 20% speed performance moving up from the i5 to the i7. The i3 is nice for those that are looking for more battery life. This one here will give you anywhere from 10 to about 13 hours of battery. And I know that because the first gen model that I had, I actually had the non-touch screen and the battery lasted forever. Getting the touch screen, you know, you get the more vibrant display. It is a glossy display, so you will get a little bit of glare from that in the direct sunlight. But the nice thing with this one is the fact that it's got a 3200 by 1800 resolution, which is incredible. So that's really nice, but you do have to pay quite a premium to get that. I think if you're just going to be doing spreadsheets, basic office work, email, things like that, the non-touch displays is probably your best bet. I just got this one here just so you guys could see the top end model. As you can see, the screen is absolutely beautiful. The colors pop, everything's vibrant. It gets extremely bright with about 400 nits of brightness. This is actually one of the brightest panels that I've used next to the Surface Pro 4. That's also another extremely bright unit. You don't normally get that bright of a unit. Let me see if this will even show up on camera. It might glare out the camera, but let's see. So you can see here, that gets pretty bright. This is a standard chiclet style keyboard with 1.3 millimeter travel. They're actually really nice. It feels good to type on. I could see if you were doing any type of journaling or a long Word document, I'd have no problem typing on this. We have a two-stage backlit keyboard, brightest, lower, and then off. This has two side-firing speakers located here down by where you rest your hands. It actually gets quite loud. It's not too bad. It's one of the loudest systems I've heard. Next to the HP Spectre X360 second gen, that one also has an extremely loud sound system, so let's take a listen now.
This is the Dell XPS 13 with a Skylake processor. That's the 6th generation processor. Let's get into it with the old handy dandy Italian toothpick here.
So you can see the sound is loud and clear. Even though they fire to the sides, it does sound really good and clear, and it's not muffled setting it in your lap or sitting it on a counter because they are on the side and not underneath. Now as far as ports go on this unit, you've got your power adapter here, your USB-C port, USB 3.0, your 3.5 millimeter headphone jack, your battery display, and on the front, this is just a charging light. So if you plug this unit in, this light actually lights up. And there's your speakers there, one on each side. And then you have your SD card reader, another USB 3.0, and a lock. And then nothing on top. System is well ventilated, as you can see here. And then underneath this little hidden flap is all your Windows information, serial, tag number, etc. Just wanted to show you what the power adapter looked like here. It's nice and small, compact, 45 watt, standard barrel connector. This is nice too, so the end lights up, so if you're trying to find this in the dark, makes it easy to plug in. And then here on the front, this lights up when it's charging. Now, one thing that I found out right away with the second gen model versus this first gen model is the fans don't kick on all the time. It used to drive me crazy, even with the basic i5 non-touch display. If I was surfing the web using Chrome, the fan would kick on like I'm doing heavy video editing or gaming. They've eliminated that on this model. I've not even had the fan come on once, even during gaming sessions. So this is definitely a better cooled system. They control the fans better. Just want to show you what it looks like here playing one of my favorite games, Hearthstone. This is one of the best games, I think, to show off the display, the colors, the vibrancy, and also the touchscreen. And this is set to full screen, 3200 by 1800, high resolution. This unit still does have the camera located down here on the bottom, which is not the best because when you're doing video conferencing, people are looking up at you, so it's usually not the best way to go, but I'd rather have it down here than up here to eliminate the bezel. This bezel is ridiculously small. I know it's kind of hard to tell on camera, but compared to another screen, this is literally about a fourth of the size of a normal bezel. So this is my thumb here, so you can see, and it's right on the edge. Truly is an edge-to-edge display. I love it. The touchscreen is extremely responsive and fluid. Works great. Never had a problem with it. Same with the touchpad. Love this touchpad. It is a glass touchpad. It's got a little bit of bounce, can you hear it? To it, clicks nice. All the features work, so two finger tapping, three fingers up to scroll through different windows that you have open. Everything seems to work well, so Dell and Microsoft have really gotten together here and made sure that they had the best drivers possible for this unit. This is one of the better laptops that have come out this year. I would compare this with the HP Spectre X360 second gen as well as the Surface Pro 4. I mean, these are all different types of systems, but they to me are the top of the line now as far as the 13-inch model goes anyways, because the SP4, even though it's a 12.3-inch, I consider that more of a 13-inch just because of the way that they've changed the ratio on that one, the 3:2 ratio, so it makes it look a little bigger. It's actually really close to this. Let me show you a side-by-side comparison and show you what I'm talking about. So you can see there the side-by-side comparison of the Dell XPS and the Microsoft Surface Pro 4, that they are so close in size. Let me show you what it looks like on top of each other so you can see what the footprint actually looks like. So you can see there that they are almost the same. The Surface Pro 4 is actually a little bit larger than the XPS 13, at least width-wise. Whereas the Dell XPS 13 is a little bit longer than the Surface Pro 4. The Surface Pro 4 with the case on weighs about 2.5 pounds, where the Dell XPS 13 non-touch model weighs, I believe it's 2.6 pounds, and when you get it with the touchscreen, then it weighs 2.8 pounds. So to me, the Dell XPS 13 second generation with the Skylake processor is a definite buy. If you're wanting to test this out, you can go into a Microsoft store. They do have these in the Signature series. Those cost just a little bit more for the high-end model, but the good thing is they don't come with all the bloatware. So when the Signature Series, when you purchase one of those, they don't have any all the extra software that comes with these laptops. So I would recommend, if you want to go see what they feel like, what they look like, go into a Microsoft store and check them out. If you have any questions or comments, please put them below. If you liked the video, please give it a thumbs up. If you love the video, go ahead and hit that subscribe button like a ninja right down below. Talk to you guys on the next one. Peace.